Greetings, Miki here. I wanted to make a little update video about my impending DK League starter character. So, let's start with a little map. Some tier 7 map currently working in my atlas to make some upgrades. And I made a few gem changes, a lot of gear upgrades, so currently having around 8k total HP. Which is pretty nice and recovering a good chunk of it most of the time without any problems. Working towards more recovery while mapping, but well, that's a thematic for a price tag basically. Cluster jewels, that's the main point I need to upgrade, but set in every item I would use until tier 16 maps basically, or until I switch to CI, if I do it. I'm not sure yet if I go for CI or stay hybrid. So I will go for this one, that's stand on the stone circles. I do one or two rounds maybe. I hate stone circles, I usually skip them. Because any build, they are very dangerous for any build. Standing still in Path of Exile is not a good idea usually. But yeah, still stuff dies. In ultimatums, that's not a problem. I just run around in circles basically and curse from time to time, and that's it. Pretty safe. In general, pretty good. I like it. Very strong build. So I will stop here because, well, let's take the rewards. But I run up to the max wave like any time in any other scenario, because it's totally worth it running those ultimatums. There's some ultimatum counter, whatever. There's some challenge for running up to 9 phases basically, so did that already. No problems in those at all. And gear wasn't expensive either so far. Pretty cheap most of the stuff. But cluster jewels will be the expensive part. Not that you need the expensive ones, but yeah, that was a bus without even using my single target. So yeah, pretty nice. So yeah, build is working fine. AoE is pretty nice, but this is gonna climb in the future as well. I need the Wine Shriek boots. The problem with Wine Shriek is you need to run a Sepulchre map for the Prophecy, which is a tier 14 map, and I haven't seen any of those sold yet of the Sepulchre maps. So I would buy the Prophecy and I would buy the map even though I haven't reached tier 14 yet. And just to make the Prophecy, but no option yet. One Shriek basically grants plus one curse and something like 22 auras and 60% increased curse AoE. So we have higher curse AoE, which is nice for clear. Of course, curse AoE is something we want. So let's go in the Blood Aqueducts. No issues at all with any content so far. Conquerors, etc. No problem. If you hear some beeping, that's PoE trade life search. What I noticed is I never knew that you can use charged mines with smoke mines. And gain frenzy and power charges from it. I gain power charges from Cane of the Unraveling at the moment. Not that I want them, but frenzy charges, that's working. Even though it states the supporter skill is detonated targeting an enemy, but they still somehow target enemies if you throw mines somewhere near enemies. So now I got my frenzy charge just from using smoke mine to move around. It's not a way for me to keep frenzies up 100% of the time, but it's nice to gain some charges from time to time. Even though on average I have something like 2 around while mapping, but if you're running an ultimatum and run around in circles and throw your mine from time to time, that you gain those charges. They will be up, no problem at all. And that's not a level 20 support, and I think there's some alt quality with charge shenanigans maybe. And this mind throwing speed climbs up with frenzy charges, so that's making the movement ability a little bit quicker as well, which is nice to have. So I won't switch away from Smogmine. I really like Smogmine. I don't know why I like it. If you want to use Flame Dash or something, you can do it. So for the other gear, so I got my Vixens. I want two red. Oh, the first one definitely red. Green and blue, basically. Two red, green, blue. That's a goal. I don't have enough chromatics or the recipes to craft something like that pretty easily. You can do some shenanigans with two sockets, three sockets, four sockets, etc. Not that hard, but I need to delve a little bit to unlock the recipes. I was too lazy yet. And I want to have Warlord Spark in there. I level it a little bit because cursed enemies grant 20 rage regenerated in 1 second. So that's perma rage, basically up to 50, or most of the time while mapping. Forward speed, 10% movement speed. And I have Endurance Charge uptime because, well, I gain with charge mines, I gain frenzy and power charges already. So that way I can gain Endurance Charges. Alternatively, as my first one, I could use Poacher's Mark for frenzy charges for guaranteed uptime, but I like 10% movement speed and endurance charges a little bit more. So that's something I wanted. I tested Warlord's Mark in a setup like this before on standard, basically. So at the moment I'm using 4 curses. Whispers of Doom plus 1 here, Vixen's grants 1 and 1 base, so I have to use 5 curses in my setup with Enfeeble, Temp Chains, Despair, Vulnerability and Elemental Weakness. Elemental Weakness does nothing, it's a curse that's get overridden, and the throwaway curse has to be the first one in line here. So that way we have the shenanigans with explosions and all the good stuff. That's how it works. Explained it in other videos before, so that's pretty nice. So if I've linked my Crane of Unraveling, I will use it a long time until I have maybe some bow and a Soul Strike on top of it. Soul Strike was the name? I think Soul Strike. And yeah, it's doing a lot of work. Decent rolls, close to maximum with Chaos Damage over Time mod, so that's nice, and 5 Link at the moment is more than enough. I barely use Blight, Soul Rend, Castwell, Channeling, Shenanigans, Cold Control Destruction would be my 6 Link. And I'm still not sure if I use it in the endgame, because standing still against many bosses is deadly, so Blight not the best option. I just might use Essence Drain and usual Essence Drain, skill gems, empower, etc. Because it has a long uptime, decently long uptime, and you can kite around more. That might be the end game for me. I level the gems in my offhand for that. So, body armor I bought for 20 chaos. 20 chaos. At Serious Splendor, and this has 576 energy shield with those rolls. And yeah, all rest on top of it, and life gain on kill. So this helps a lot with my life sustain. Got my life regen still on life, and well, life last, but and on top of it, I got some brush with death for life on kill and energy shield on kill. But this helps a lot. I mean, this helps a lot. 10 mobs are 20% life on kill, and on top the one person thing, that's 30% life on kill I gain, and for ultimatums, etc. I don't need to watch my life at all, basically. That's the thing. Grants plus 1 level to all wild skills, which at the moment works for my wild blight, so that's nice, plus 1 level there. So pretty sweet, a lot of energy shield, almost 600 energy shield. Very nice, cheap body armor. 5 linked it, and I'm fine at the moment with that. I think I can, without any issues, kill Shaper on a 5 link on both. So, or Elder or something like that. Maybe not invitations, etc., but up to tier 16, I don't see any problems with using a 5 link, so I don't have a hurry to 6 link stuff. Yeah, for the helmet, bought this one for 10k or something like that. Not too expensive, just ES and resist, and some life on it because I'm hybrid at the moment, so that's working out for me. And like I said, smoke mine in here, charge mines, discipline, and malevolence. I switched to malevolence because I don't have any mana issues at all anymore. I can use two curses and regenerate pretty quickly, and I recover a lot of mana on kill from the body armor alone. So with that body armor, I basically don't need mana and mana gain on killing blow here. I don't really need it. 16% max mana helps a little bit, but I lose this body armor. I don't really need it, but I'm too lazy to respec it, so I keep it. Amulet, some energy shield, life, dex. That's basically it, and even forgot to anoint something. Pretty new amulet. Energy shield, life, resist, basically. Energy shield, life, resist. Same with the belt, energy shield, life, resist, some stats, strengths in that case. So I wanted stats on those items. And yeah, I'm set with around 8k total HP without any Timeless Jewel shenanigans or something like that, just from the passive tree and the gear. And none of the items costed me more than 10 chaos, basically. Pretty damn sure, I think the belt even just 8, something like that. Can find some stuff. This one found it myself, nothing too special. I think I can upgrade my life roll on it if I really want. Maybe I do it. Let's go for it. Yeah. One tier higher? Yeah, a little bit higher. Okay. But I don't care about the boots because I will use Wind Shriek over time. I will replace them, and that's just an armor base, no energy shield base as well, similar resist. And I didn't want to change anything about the boots because of that. It's an upgrade anyway, so I didn't account for that. So yeah, flask, nothing too special. I can sustain my blight. That's a good thing about blight and cast while channeling Solrent. The mana cost is pretty low. Better than a 5 link blight, for example. I can easily sustain my mana regen without any big investment or something like that for single target. So I don't need to care about that part. While discipline, very important. You wanna refill energy shield from time to time in ultimatum, that helps a lot. And that's basically it for the gear. Nothing too special, and this gear will carry me a long, long way. I don't need to improve anything special here. For the passive tree, I respect those nodes here, those 4 points. Went with this road, save 1 point there. Removed my starter position, but still kept some life nodes. So basically, if I wanna go CI, I just remove all the life nodes and invest into cluster jewels instead, which also grant me then energy shield, etc. Got subline sensation, which is nice for hybrids, but I would need to change some cluster jewels and have a decent amount set of second cluster jewel. Because I use a staff at the moment, I expect source nodes because area of effect, very nice. Area of effect is always nice for clearing for such huge AoE skills. And going for the next cluster jewel here, maybe I start with a medium one first and then go for a large one and add the medium, etc. I worked my way towards it, but then at some point I might want to just switch to CI with something like 7k energy shields, 6.5, 7k, and then I feel good using CI. But first I need cluster jewels, a proper one, proper ones. So, I bought this medium cluster jewel for 5 or 8 chaos. I think 8 chaos. that was a steal. It has wish for death, culling strike against cursed enemies, and evil eye for blind. Every time I curse, I blind for 4 seconds, and that's insane safety in while clearing, while doing ultimatums, etc. That's really insane. Very cheap, but you find those usually more expensive. So you want Evil Eye, Wish for Death, not that important. So if you go for a budget, use Evil Eye only, and maybe something else. Like I said, small cluster jewels, didn't aim for something special, but Sublime Sensation worked for me. For the large one, I just used Wicked Paul, Touch of Cruelty, nothing special here, just wanted an 8 passive one with some stuff on it. And the other one, not good as well. It's not good. I wanted Unwavering Evil, but that's something I want in large cluster jewels. Because Chaos Skill ignore interruptions from stuns, so I can channel Blight, etc. and cannot be stunned. And that's something I wanted to change a long time. Enfeeble for Despair. And use Despair, so I'm immune to stuns while even using my cursor, so I cannot be stunned out of the animation while casting. So that's nice as well, because it's a chaos skill. So I'm stun immune while doing any actions. Pretty good, I would say. And on top, Brian King here. Which works out in any other case when I'm, I don't know, stunned while using a smoke mine or something. So yeah, that's it for the cluster jewels. Need to upgrade a lot of those, especially the medium stuff, large stuff. One brush for death at the moment. I want in the end 3 brush for with death on medium mods and other small ones, so I can recover 3% life and 3% energy shield on kill, which is more than enough for anything basically. So yeah, that's very nice. I even picked up Essence Surge to help my ES recharge. That's mainly for bossing, when I rely more on ES recharge and less on ES on kill stuff, shenanigans. You wanna dodge attacks and recover the ES on its own in most encounters of hard bosses basically. So that's the day 2 recap basically, not finished with the day. The video is coming shortly after the day 1 recap because I forgot to post the video. So yeah, there's a lot of work going on, and yeah, the basic passive tree is done. Just cluster jewels basically, upgrades. That's where I have to spend my currency next basically, and the wine shriek. And I'm pretty much set for, I don't know, for wins, big wins. Okay, yeah, if you like, follow me or add some comments. Tell me something, I don't know, if you played the build, copied it, or play something similar, let me know how it works out for you. I am having a complete blast with it. It's insanely good. The clear is very nice for the price tag, and single target is still very nice. One tapping Ubaid Zaro and all the good stuff with one DK, and it's really fun, and I don't think I will have any problems with tier 16 guardian bosses, etc. At all. Invitations probably, because dot build not that high in damage, but anything up to that point shouldn't be a problem. Okay, have a nice day. Bye bye.